there perfectly, which is why we're not forecasting the ideal setup for tornadoes. But there could be a couple. We're looking at Kansas overnight, then stretching into Kansas into Missouri for Tuesday, eventually getting all the way into Illinois. So yes, there will be that zone of severe weather. Tonight, it's mostly Kansas, including Wichita, maybe all the way to Kansas City. Hail, wind, and isolated tornado threat can't be ruled out. A much larger zone tomorrow, though, Oklahoma, Arkansas, into Missouri, into Illinois. That's that front and that area of low pressure. But that's only number one. Number two is on its heels. And so by Wednesday, there's another round of severe weather. We'll go through that setup again, right? Warm, moist air at the low levels, so south to north. Then the low-level jet stream going kind of southwest to northeast. So again, we have that turn with height in the atmosphere, which will start to give us some organized severe storms. And we'll be able to follow that develop Wednesday through the day. And again, it looks like Oklahoma into Arkansas really blossoming into the afternoon hours. Once we get some of that daytime heating going, the afternoon into the evening, that line of storms could form. So although there could be some isolated storms in the beginning with a tornado threat, the later you go in the day, the more likely it will be for a line of storms with wind damage over a pretty large area. Viv, over to you.
All right. Do you have spring break this week? Well, heads up for you. We have storms that could interrupt your plans. In particular, down here in Florida, already kind of gloomy at Daytona Beach. Look at the low clouds. Not many folks out on the beach, but rightfully so. And as we look at the extended forecast for you, Daytona Beach, look at this. Rain or thunderstorms every day this week. Temperatures remaining pretty consistent in the mid and upper 70s to low 80s. Actually, we're talking mid 80s on Thursday, 86 degrees. But again, each day we have a thunderbolt or either a raindrop in the forecast. So just prepare for that. Not the best of beach weeks here at Daytona Beach. Back to you, Mark.
And Viv, one of those things you have to watch out for as you look towards the beaches is a threat of rip currents. Now, this is the time of year, again, people are just getting back into the waters. You're not used to it. Here's how the a rip current can set up. You have that inbound current going over the sandbar. The waves are breaking. There, if you're seeing breaking waves, that's the inbound current. That kind of quiet area that you think is safer is actually the more dangerous zone. Without those breaking waves, you don't have them there because that's where the rip current forms. That's where the kind of the circulation converges and you get that narrow band of water racing away from shore. As we turn this on its head and look down from above, it is a narrow current and it will be bringing both the water and you, if you're in it, away from land and out towards the ocean. And the natural instinct is to try to swim directly back towards shore. But the best way to get out of a rip current is actually to swim parallel to shore, getting out of the rip and using those inbound currents to actually help push you back towards land. That's something to keep in mind. Instead of panicking, just go parallel. Eventually, you'll start moving right back towards your beach towel.
All right. Meanwhile, it's a cold start to the week across the Northeast.
That's true. Temperatures more than 20 degrees below average in some places. We'll tell you how long that cool weather will stick around.
Plus, so look at how harsh this winter is causing a problem for a breakfast table staple. All right.
Currently in our area, 86 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, generally cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 88. Tonight, some clouds. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 68. Winds west at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, partly cloudy. Slight chance of a rain shower. High 87. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Take Zequel and sleep like the kids went to Nana's house for the whole weekend. Zequel, the non-habit forming sleep aid that helps you sleep easily and wake refreshed, because sleep is a beautiful thing.
Tired of working for peanuts? Well, what if I told you that peanuts can work for you? That's right. I'm talking full-time delivery of 7 grams of protein and 6 essential nutrients. You ever seen a peanut take a day off? I didn't think so. Harness the hard-working power of the peanut.
I love making Sunday dinners, but when my back hurt, cooking all day, forget about it. Tylenol was okay, but it was 6 pills a day. But Aleve is just 2 pills all day. And now,
family.
I'm back.
Aleve. Discover Can-Am's wide range of industry-leading vehicles during the Ready to Ride sales event. For a limited time, the Outlander L starts at $59.99. Or get the versatile Commander, the powerful Outlander, and the turbocharged Maverick XDS. With cash rebates up to $2,000. Don't miss out. Visit your local dealer during the Ready to Ride sales event. Can-Am, the ride says it all.
You know, some people have told me reverse mortgages sound too good to be true. I mean, you get cash out of your home, no monthly payments, and still own your home. There's got to be a catch, right, Jesse? Well, there isn't. It's like any other mortgage, only with reverse mortgage, the loan's paid back when the last borrower leaves the home. In fact, reverse mortgages are based on a notion that President Reagan signed into law over 25 years ago in order to help seniors remain in their homes. If you're 62 or older and own your own home, you may qualify for a government-insured reverse mortgage with AAG that allows you to turn the equity in your home into tax-free cash. And with AAG, there are never any credit score requirements.
Call 1-800-661-0312 now to receive a new free information kit, including a reverse mortgage guide and DVD, personal stories from people like you, and a brand new family guide for children and loved ones, all absolutely free with no obligation.
AAG can help you pay off credit card debt, eliminate monthly mortgage payments, and provide some real retirement security.
Call 1-800-661-0312 today to get your free AAG reverse mortgage information kit and bonus DVD.
In the kit, you'll receive a helpful three-part guide. The first will show you how a government-insured reverse mortgage allows you to access the equity in your home as tax-free cash. 500,000 people have already done it. The second booklet contains stories told by people just like you who've had their lives changed forever using a reverse mortgage. And the third guide is full of helpful answers and information for children and loved ones.
Call 1-800-661-0312 now to receive your information kit and DVD, all absolutely free.
They're simply an effective way for folks you need to enjoy your retirement.
Call 1-800-661-0312 now to receive your information kit and DVD, all absolutely free. Call 1-800-661-0312 now.
AAG, the best advice for a better life.
Hut, hut. When it comes to losing weight, everyone has a number. And if you want to get your performance back and feel great, do what I did. One call and I lost it all. 22 pounds gone.
Lose weight fast with Nutrisystem's Fast 5 Plus Kit. Lose 5 pounds in your first week, plus 1 inch off your waist or your money back, guaranteed.
Nutrisystem has everything you need to feel better, look better, and perform better at any age, faster than ever before.
I haven't felt this good in years. Thank you, Nutrisystem. I lost 8 pounds in the first week.
Order your 28-day Nutrisystem plan right now, including Fast 5 Plus. Get 1 week of meals, plus 1 week of energizing shakes and craving crusher shakes, free. New food selections, new expert guides. Call now and lock in 2014 prices, and shipping is free.
Whether your number's 10 or 50, make the right call. Nutrisystem.
Call 855-789-THIN now and lose your first 5 pounds fast.
You are watching the Weather Channel. Thank you so much for joining us. We're watching Philadelphia right now as we have fair conditions in the area. You can see just a few high-level cirrus clouds overhead. We're expecting highs in the 70s later on in the week, so things will be gradually warming up for us over the Northeast. But what's our weather headlines for you? The chill. It begins to ease. So again, that does mean that we will notice a warmer scenario as we progress through the week. But look at the conditions right now. Temperatures in the middle 30s in Philadelphia, the same in New York City, but only 20s up toward Boston. And look at the teens that we're finding back toward Binghamton, New York, only 17 degrees at this hour. We have the dip in the jet stream. And you know, you hear us say it all the time, the jet stream pretty much the dividing line of the cold from the warm. side of the jet stream, the northern side, that means you have the colder air. But when you get on the southern side of the jet stream, that means a warm-up is expected for you. And that's exactly what we're expecting, as the jet stream will change configuration for you in Philadelphia, even New York City, even up to the Hartford area. Notice how it pushes to our north, and that means some milder conditions expected as we progress into the middle and latter part of the week. So today's highs not getting out of the mid-30s, we don't think, in New York City, maybe even only up to about 30 degrees in Boston. Now tomorrow, slightly warmer, up to 38 in Boston, mid-40s in New York City, and that will be the case on Wednesday. Really warming up in Boston, 46 by midweek, and we talk about that being only 3 degrees below average versus well below average by some 10 to 15 degrees as we started off the week. So here's a look at the forecast for you, New York City. Again, a gradual warm up, but look how we'll really jump up to the warm conditions on Thursday, forecasting a high of 66, and that's almost 15 degrees above average. Back to you, Mark.
Now an important question. Have you eaten pancakes or waffles recently? And did you use maple syrup? Well, spring's late arrival is making it tough on the farmers who make that maple syrup. Lyle Merrifield owns Merrifield Farm in Gorham, Maine, and joins us live now. First, Lyle, thanks so much for joining us today.
Oh, you're welcome, Mark. Thanks for asking.
Let's talk about this maple syrup and weather. How does that combine in order to get us that delightful addition to breakfast?
Well, the weather hasn't really cooperated with most of the producers, that's for sure. It's been awfully cold, and we've had some very moderate runs. I mean, there has been some syrup made in the southern part of the state, but certainly we haven't been into the season as deep as we normally are by this time.
So you're saying cold not good for your progress on getting maple syrup. Why is that? What's the ideal condition for harvesting?
Well, what we like to have is we like to have certainly freezing evenings and nights, but we need that temperature to be up to 40, maybe 45 by 10 or 11 the next day to get the sap flow moving in those trees.
And that's because the sap itself would be frozen and thus not running out of the trees?
Correct. Yep.
So give me your ideal setup. Other than, like, does it affect the weather? Does the weather affect the quality of that sap that you'll get? If you get those temperatures to be ideal, is that then ideal maple syrup?
Absolutely. It makes you good sap production, and with the cool nights, it keeps everything preserved well. So with those fluctuations in temperature, it can certainly give us, excellent sap yields. And looking at the forecast ahead of us, it looks like we're going to get some of those conditions that we need.
And we're looking at some of the images on the screen right now of the different colors of maple syrup. How does that come into play? Is that related to the weather at all, or just the tree that you're getting it from?
All right, it can be, and it can be the tree you're getting it from, but typically your different grades of syrup will be put into the time of the season. As the season drags on, normally you're making a darker syrup.
All right, Lyle, thanks so much for the information. Fascinating stuff, and hopefully we'll get that perfect ideal condition so we can get more maple syrup flowing soon.
We need our maple syrup, right? Well, stay with us. Winter is not giving up easily ahead. Who can expect to see snow from not one, but two blasts of winter weather? Plus, a group of young scientists and inventors displayed their new ideas at the White House this morning. We'll tell you.
Sometimes bigger is better. But other times, bigger just gets in the way. At Brother, we know the biggest printer isn't always the best fit for every office. So we've come up with a bigger idea. Don't supersize, optimize. See how we can help you put the right printers in all the right places and help reduce your costs. Now that's big. Brother, at your side. Learn more at don'tsupersizeoptimize.com.
You don't know your credit
score? I don't know my credit score.
That's really important. I mean,
I don't know my credit
score. Don't you want to buy a house, like, ever? You should probably check out Credit Karma. It's free.
Credit Karma. Free.
Credit Karma. Really free credit scores.
So let's go!
When you go out there, it's dangerous.
You know those neighbors always making weird inventions out of junk in their garage? We just gave them their own TV show.
I think I just made Mother Nature my bitch.
One man's trash.
This is perfect.
Is another man's wood-powered Jeep gasifier.
Brainstormers, Sundays at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 86 degrees under mostly cloudy skies.
This afternoon, generally cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 88. Tonight, some clouds. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 68. Winds west at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, partly cloudy. Slight chance of a rain shower. High 87. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Viking and introducing the all-new Viking 6. The hardest working, most off-road capable side-by-sides in America. Built for the hardest working people on earth. You.
It's more than a network. It's how you stay connected. With CenturyLink as your trusted technology partner, you get an industry-leading broadband network and cloud and hosting services. CenturyLink, your link to what's next.
The wizarding world of Harry Potter, now with Diagon Alley and the Hogwarts Express. Come and live it. Universal Orlando Resort.
I have a cold. With terrible chest congestion. Better take something.
Theraflu Severe Cold doesn't treat chest congestion.
Really?
New Alka-Seltzer Plus Day Powder rushes relief to your worst cold symptoms plus chest congestion.
Oh, what a relief it is.
Here we go!
Attention Medicare beneficiaries. Health reform has added significant new benefits to Medicare plans. If you have Medicare Part A, Part B, Part D, or any Medicare Advantage plan, you now get benefits with no copays, no deductibles, and can get dental, vision, and prescription coverage included. Call the Medicare Health Reform Helpline now to make sure you have all the benefits you're entitled to. Call the Medicare Health Reform Helpline now to update your plan.
Hi, I'm Dr. Jason Buchwald. The cost of health insurance and the denial of coverage because of pre-existing conditions has been a serious problem in America. But now the law has changed. Healthcare reform is now available. So many people do not take advantage of the benefits offered to them by healthcare reform because they don't call. Call now.
The Medicare Health Reform Helpline is now accepting calls. Don't miss the deadline. Call the Medicare Health Reform Helpline.
Call 800-399-2752. That's 800-399-2752. 800-399-2752.
One look at that Red Baron pizza, and you're gonna love it from the first bite to the last. Because a perfect pizza requires a perfect crust. The sauce commands your attention. The cheese begs you to savor every bite. The pepperoni declares you have reached pizza nirvana. And that last slice?
What's it worth to you?
A perfect crust means a better pizza. Red Baron, love at first bite. Pick up a pizza you can call your own. Red Baron Singles.
Experts say replace your mattress every 8 years. And get this, during the Rooms to Go anniversary sale, you can buy a Tempur-Pedic mattress and get 8 years interest-free financing. That's right, 8 years. Who offers financing for that long? Rooms to Go, of course. So now you can have that Tempur-Pedic mattress you've always wanted, 2,920 nights of great Tempur-Pedic sleep until 2023, 8 years from now, when it's time to get your next Tempur-Pedic mattress. So just hurry to Rooms to Go now during our anniversary sale.
So let's go!
When you go out there, it's dangerous.
All right, it is time now for the winter weather update. And the first thing we want to talk about is a winter clipper system that we've been following over parts of the Midwest. It has dumped heavy amounts of snow just to the south of Minneapolis and even over the southwestern parts of Wisconsin. This is what's left of that system as it slides across the lower peninsula of Michigan. Most of this action is to your south, as you notice, Detroit. We're not expecting any heavy accumulations for you. But notice as we cross over into northwest Ohio, we're watching some of the heavy heavier snow. Cleveland will keep your radar turned on as well. And notice how it stretches across the northern parts of Indiana. So still reports of snow. Now, we've had a couple of inches officially at the downtown area in Chicago, up to 5 inches, though, at the airport. And just north and west, it looks like another little piece of this system is trying to push on in. So we'll continue to keep your radar turned on as well as this system continues to slide on off to the east. So it's moving away from the Minneapolis-St. Paul area. Now, speaking of you, Minneapolis, we're watching another system that will make its way into your area. So the second round of snow is expected for you as we look at the next 24 to 48 hours. Not from the Clipper system that we're watching today, but from another that will make its way south of the border. So let's check out this next little dose of wintry weather that we're finding. More spring snow as we progress through the early part of the week. There is the jet stream. Notice how it'll be pushing most of the system south of the border, and they'll pretty much clip their way across the Great Lakes area. There you see some of the colder air coming into the Dakotas and much of Minnesota, including around the Minneapolis-St. Paul area. All the while, we'll be bringing in the moisture now out ahead of the system, but nonetheless, this system will have a double-sided pattern to it with the chance of some stronger storms ahead of it, but the colder air and additional snow back across the northern parts of the Dakotas and parts of Minnesota, including some wet snow maybe on the southwest side of you, Minneapolis. So this is tomorrow night. Again, a wintry mix coming into the western Great Lakes area, much of the Midwest into the western High Plains. And here is a look at Wednesday. So some pretty hefty amounts of additional snow. After all, it is spring season. So that's why we're talking about hefty amounts. But I tell you what, we had a pretty big deficit in terms of snow so far this winter season, including Minneapolis, some 19-inch deficit in the area. Back to you, Mark.
Now, Viv, have you ever met a 12-year-old CEO? What about owning a patent on new tech before even owning a driver's license? Well, the White House was full of kids that did this very thing this morning, and our own Anaritis Rodriguez introduces us to some of them.
It's not every day the president gets to shoot a marshmallow through an air gun across the state dining room. But at the White House Science Fair, innovations like this kid-designed device get presidential praise, some play.
Let's go look at the marshmallow, see what happens.
And maybe even a patent.
My invention is the Hiccupop. It's a lollipop that treats the hiccups, and I applied for a patent.
And you actually got it?
Yes, I got it about a year ago.
So you can sell this on the market?
Yes.
Don't be fooled by their age.
I want to be an engineer.
We invented a device that can help people turn pages in a book.
Already, many of these kids are CEOs of their own companies.
I want to actually start the company and I profit, expand.
So you want to be the CEO of your own company?
Yes, ma'am.
Joshua LePage's product, a magnetic wristband that can charge a phone without electricity. For the fifth year, more than 100 of the country's youngest and brightest minds putting their science experiments to the presidential test.
I'm 16 years old, and I created a wearable sensor system that detects the wandering of Alzheimer's patients.
The National Science Foundation says three quarters of professionals working in STEM fields are men. The fair's purpose is to encourage more girls and minorities to study science.
I just really want to inspire people to do something bigger and have more women in technology, really.
What a cool group of kids, that's for sure.
Oh, yeah.
Still coming up on Weather Center Live, we are trying to find spring somewhere.
Yes, we're looking hard, far and beyond. A winter mess this morning and another cold snap on the way for the eastern half of the country. We'll tell you all about it.
Currently in our area, 87 degrees, under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, generally cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 88. Tonight, some clouds. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 68. Winds west at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, partly cloudy. Slight chance of a rain shower. High 87. Here's our 7-day outlook.
to moving snowmakers surprised drivers and pedestrians alike, and why this won't be the only winter sting this week.
Plus, get ready to grab those umbrellas to shield yourself from rain, from wind, and from even more messy weather, where storms could flip those umbrellas inside out as spring showers take a nasty turn.
Thanks for joining us for Weather Center Live. I'm Vivian Brown.
And I'm Mark Elliott. You know, some of you were just crawling your way to work today, and not because you imbibed a little too much over the weekend. Snow was the reason for that slow go.
Yes, Chicago, one place where a blast of snow dampened the roads and coated road sides. It slowed down more than travel, though, on the roads.
Yeah, officials at Chicago's O'Hare International say flights were delayed an average of 40 minutes at times earlier this morning because of that snow and ice. And so we had to stick one of our own out in that mess. Mm-hmm. Keith Carson got a firsthand look at Chicago's spring snow sting.
And he gives us an update now on the snow just outside of the Windy City.
Here in Chicago, it was 73 degrees as of last Monday. Things have changed in a very big way here with a clipper that moved through. A little extra oomph in this clipper as compared to your normal storms that you see come through the Midwest. You usually think about 1 to 3 inches of snow with those. Not really the case with this one. Looks like we're going to be overachieving. This is 294 here. This is southbound, a major interstate that basically runs on the outside of Chicago as a bypass. That's why you see a lot of trucks on it. That's southbound, that's northbound, and you can see the visibility greatly reduced here. That's a big problem. Chicago, obviously, pretty good at dealing with snow. They do have a lot of plows out. They salt the roads as well. However, when the snowfall rates increase, and we've seen moderate and even S+, so heavy snow come through, it's going to be hard to keep the roads clear in that situation. As far as accumulation, already coming in about 3 to 3.5 inches of snow that will continue, will taper off later on this afternoon. There is some hope in sight, though, which is that by Wednesday, Chicago, this Chicago right here, should be around 60 degrees.
Keith, that is a nice switch, that's for sure. But this latest blast of winter weather is a fast mover. Despite that, it's got a history of some very impressive snowfall amounts out there. Let's put this into motion. Since yesterday, that swath of snow along and just north of the path of the Clipper low. So most areas saw 3, maybe 4 inches of snow. But look at Finnamore. Over 1.5 feet. Yes, an overachieving snowstorm for some of you. That is a big deal snowstorm, although it was a fast mover and there is that warm up on the way. Viv, some areas still getting snow right now.
Yes, I'd show you exactly the areas that's still picking up the snow from this little clipper system, fast moving as it may be. We started to clear out a little bit from the first round of snow in the Chicago area, but right on its backside now, we're noticing some additional snow coming down from the Waukegan area. So certainly the northwestern suburbs of UChicago could pick up maybe an additional inch or two. So we're watching it. But again, you can see the bulk of the heavier snow is off to the east, crossing over northern Indiana into Ohio. And there is the main energy with this very fast moving system. So here is a look at the timeline as we detail the rest of the afternoon into the evening hours. Notice how it does totally dry out here as the bulk of the snow moves on off to the south, even clear out over northern Indiana and northwest Ohio. So Detroit, Cleveland, we don't think you'll get any heavy accumulations from this particular system. So from this point on until midnight tonight, again, not anticipating any additional accumulations for the area. So here you go, Chicago, your specific forecast. The snow winding down as we speak. So as we go through the rest of the evening and overnight hours, we'll just be left with cloudy conditions, but no snow coming from these clouds. But look at these temperatures remaining right around the freezing mark. Back to you, Mark.
And Viv, despite the fact that we still have snow on the map, we're also looking at that potential of severe weather. Kansas City, you are in the crosshairs of some of this severe weather that's upcoming in the next couple of days. Right now in the low 40s, but believe it or not, you're looking at some severe storms coming into play by tomorrow. So let's go through the setup here. This is the first real chance of the month for many of you to see severe storms, which means the first real chance for the year. And it's a 1-2 punch of storms coming across the center of the country. We're out of practice, right? Look at the last time that we had watches and warnings issued by these National Weather Service offices. It's been since October to see a tornado watch for Kansas City, Springfield, Wichita, and Tulsa. You did have a warning in Wichita in December. Otherwise, it's October for the warnings, too. Again, the bottom line is that we haven't seen a lot of these for the past several months, so now's the time to get those plans into the works. Know how to get those watches and warnings. Know where to go if a warning is issued for your neck of the woods. We start things out tomorrow. We got a southerly wind bringing up that moisture. Cold front will be lifting that moisture up into the air, but as you go up into the air, the wind direction's a little bit different. The low-level jet stream coming across that southerly flow at a very different angle, and that provides some of the spin, some of the twist in the atmosphere. You notice the upper level jet stream is also turned, especially compared to the lowest level winds. So the bottom line is that we're going to have some of that rotation built into the atmosphere that will help support some of those organized severe thunderstorms. It does appear that it kicks off in Kansas through the evening into tonight, then stretches from Kansas into Missouri and Illinois as we go through the day on Tuesday. So that's something to watch for storm number one. And in that zone will be places like Wichita and like Kansas City tonight with damaging winds and hail, potentially a tornado threat as well. And by tomorrow, we kind of stretch out that zone a little bit further from as far south and west as southern Oklahoma all the way up through St. Louis tomorrow. Again, hail and wind the biggest threats, but we can't rule out an isolated tornado threat as well. Then we do this whole game again by midweek. Notice there's a second storm going over many of these same areas, and again, we have that spin. The lowest level winds coming out of the south, then the low level jet stream is more southwest to northeast, and you also have the upper level winds that are definitely turned, although not completely on top of the other winds. They're not stacked perfectly. So again, it's not the ideal scenario for tornadoes. That is the good news, but there's enough spin that we could see some organized storms, including tornadoes, out there on Wednesday. Once again, it starts off over Oklahoma, Arkansas, and Missouri, organizing into more of a straight line wind event as we go in towards the end of the day Wednesday, but we have a pretty good zone of severe weather potential here on Wednesday, so we got to switch our minds. It's severe weather. And again, over to you.
All right, thanks, Mark. And as Mark mentioned, this could be a week of wild rides. We're talking rain, wind, and even the threat of more storms. Discover where in the South you need to keep an eye to the sky. Meanwhile, to boldly go where quite few have gone before, but for longer than any of them, meet the man who plans to break NASA's record for the time spent in space. We'll talk more with him when we...
A witness when you set the world in motion. The full line of Ram ProMaster vans and the all-new Ram ProMaster City. Purpose-built to help you run the town. Ram.
Incredible. I've been Claritin Clear for 10 days.
When your allergy symptoms start, doctors recommend taking one Claritin every day of your allergy season for continuous relief.
With powerful 24-hour non-drowsy Claritin, live Claritin Clear. Every day.
Something entirely new is being built into Bounty. Dawn. New Bounty with Dawn. Just rinse and ring. So you can blast right through tough messes and pick up more.
Whew, aren't we clever?
New Bounty with Dawn.
You can't always be there to protect her down the road. Make sure the tires she's riding on will. With the revolutionary Michelin Premier Tire, even as it wears down over time, its safety doesn't, thanks to Evergrip technology. The Michelin Premier Tire, safe when new, safe when worn.
We all have moments where we triumph in the face of adversity. Where we give back and we don't give up. That's what makes us all, in our own way, heroes. WWE, for the hero in all of us.
Currently in our area, 87 degrees, under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, generally cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 88. Tonight, some clouds. a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 68. Winds west at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, partly cloudy. Slight chance of a rain shower. High 87. Here's our 7-day outlook.
At Ancestry, we call it a hint. Simply type in a name and follow the Ancestry leaf far into your family's past. A past filled with stories that intrigue and inspire. And in doing so, reveal the one unique, improbable, and completely remarkable path that led to you. Discover your story. Start searching for free now at Ancestry.com.
Ugh, heartburn.
Did someone say burn? Try Alka-Seltzer Relief Chews. They work just as fast and are proven to taste better than Tums Smoothies assorted fruit.
Mmm, amazing.
Yeah, I get that a lot.
Alka-Seltzer Heartburn Relief Chews. Enjoy the relief.
Trimming an unruly bush in average work pants. Trimming an unruly bush in Duluth Flex Fire Hose work pants. Duluth Flex Fire Hose Work Pants. Crouch, climb, conquer comfortably. Get a pair. Only at DuluthTrading.com.
All right, you're good to go with a Coke and a smile as we have no storm trouble right now, Atlanta, as we look live from atop the world headquarters of Coca-Cola. But unfortunately, that smile could be turned upside down later in the week because we could hear the sound of thunder with rain and storms in the forecast. So let's check it out as we detail the spring storms over the south as we progress earlier in the week. This is a look at the local radar out of Orlando and Central Florida, as this is where we've had the bulk of the showers over parts of the south so far. This little line seems to be breaking apart a little bit as it slides just north of Lake Okeechobee, and we're beginning to notice this line develop just to south of Jacksonville. But the setup shows an area of low pressure, the trailing cold front. Here is the warm front bowing northward, and all of the moist flow coming in across the central and southern peninsula. So as we go through the day today, it'll primarily be over central Florida that those showers and storms will be most prevalent throughout the day. And then, of course, as we go through the evening and overnight hours, the threat of the showers and storms will diminish. Here's a look at the forecast again right around 10 o'clock this evening. That's when we'll totally kind of eliminate the chances of showers as we'll just give way to mostly cloudy conditions. Mark?
Now onto the other side of the world. There's been word of an earthquake in Japan today. Now, Japanese officials say it was a magnitude 4.1 quake, a relatively minor earthquake with little damage expected. But this is a little bit unusual. Japan, famous for earthquakes, but not where this one was centered. The epicenter was just north of Tokyo, and seeing earthquakes that close to all those people is a little bit unusual there. Now turning to the weather making headlines today. Residents of Australia's Northern Territory is still shaken by the damage done by Cyclone Nathan.
Oh, well, when the wind started, it was making this huge roaring noise. And my furniture on the veranda started flying around everywhere. And I looked out the window and there's my daughter's house next door with the roof folding itself in two.
My goodness, Nathan, the second cyclone to hit some towns in this part of Australia. Cyclone Lamb struck just last month. Now, Australia TV says that Nathan hit one remote mining town with more force than any other cyclone in living memory in that region. My goodness.
All right. Well, from troubles on this planet, we turn to planet Mars. But before man heads to Mars, NASA wants to learn all it can about the effect time and space has on humans.
That's why one of a pair of twin astronauts plans to spend an entire year in space. Our own Stephanie Abrams explains.
In the quest to fly a manned mission to Mars, two astronauts are providing NASA with a one-of-a-kind experiment.
We used to finish each other's sentences, but that's just because we grew up together.
Mark and Scott Kelly are identical twins. Scott, on the right, will spend an entire year living abroad the International Space Station. That'll be a NASA record.
This is really going to help us learn a lot about, you know, the negative effects of space on our human physiology, and then hopefully we'll figure out how to mitigate that.
Mark, who's married to former Congresswoman Gabby Giffords, will stay on the ground.
It is very exciting.
Dr. John Charles heads NASA's human research. His team will be comparing the two astronauts to see how space affects a human body over extended periods.
But what we hope to learn is what we need to learn, what is still remaining to be understood before we definitively and confidently say we're go for Mars.
Scott will be joined on the ISS by a Russian cosmonaut for the year-long stay. During that time, Scott will perform a number of experiments as well as undergo a battery of medical tests so researchers can compare results with his genetic double on the ground. The brothers already know there will be one difference after the mission: their height, due to the lack of gravity.
Yeah, this time, hopefully it'll last long enough that I can get back to the U.S. and look down at him a little bit.
Soon the whole world will be looking up as Scott Kelly begins his year-long journey in space.
You're looking up at your weather, too.
Look! This is the new Asian-inspired broth bowl from Panera Bread. Our hero is the soba noodle, which we pair with fresh spinach.
Ah,
mushrooms.
Yes.
And chicken raised without antibiotics.
Very nice.
Then top with a soy miso broth. That noise! Panera broth bowls should be slurped with gusto. Yum. To explore further, order online or visit your neighborhood Panera Bread.
You're driving a high-performance car, but you're still wearing your indoor eyeglasses in the glare of the sun? Experience Xperio UV, superior polarized sun lenses, and experience the difference. You're using high-tech skis, and you're not wearing Xperio UV on the slopes? They eliminate 100% of blinding reflective glare and offer the maximum UV protection. Think your tropical vacation can't get any better than this? Ask your eye care professional about Xperio UV, superior polarized sun lenses, in your prescription. For the best vision under the sun.
It may seem strange, but people really can love their laxative, especially when it's Miralax. It hydrates, eases, and softens to unblock your system naturally, so you have peace of mind from start to finish. Love your laxative, Miralax.
According to the U.S. Department of Energy, most homes have air leaks and drafts that waste so much energy, it's like leaving a window open in your home all year long. Don't let another year go by. Call Champion Windows at 844-4-CHAMPION. And right now, when you buy two rooms of windows, you get the third room free. Plus, Champion now offers no money down, no payments, and no interest for 12 months. So call 844-4-CHAMPION today. Because every home needs a champion.
Hydroxycut Gummies, a fun and delicious way to lose weight. America's number one weight loss brand. Lose weight your way. Bring on the
fire. You know your dentures can move.
Unlike natural teeth,
try Fixident Plus TrueFeel. The smooth formula helps keep dentures in place. It's free of flavors and colorants for a closer feeling to natural teeth. Fixident and forget it.
You know those neighbors always making weird inventions out of junk in their garage? We just gave them their own TV show.
Come on, Wind.
I think I just made Mother Nature my bitch.
One man's trash.
This is perfect.
Is another man's wood-powered Jeep gasifier.
Brainstormers, Sundays at 9, only on the Weather.
When you're in pain, an hour seems like a day seems like a month. Resolute Pain Solutions offers same-day, next-day appointments for evaluation and treatment. Our pain management specialists have the knowledge and experience in state-of-the-art procedures to relieve pain and get you moving. Patients in pain no longer have to endure unnecessary suffering while waiting for an appointment. Resolute Pain Solutions. Stop hurting. Start living today. Visit ResoluteMD.com/TV.
It makes me happy to go on the computer. I like feeling smart.
Internet Essentials from Comcast has brought low-cost internet access to over 1.4 million low-income people at home.
Internet Essentials helped me progress in my schoolwork. It helped my grades move higher.
Today, it's the largest broadband adoption program in America.
It helped me a lot.
Comcast NBC Universal, helping to bridge the digital divide.
8-1.
So let's go!
When you go out there, it's dangerous.
Currently in our area, 86 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, generally cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 88. Tonight, some clouds. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 68. Winds west at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, partly cloudy. Slight chance of a rain shower. High 87. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Good afternoon, Minneapolis. It's still a cloudy day, right? And cloudy and cold, between 31 and 32 being reported across the area right now, but windy, so it feels like the low 20s. Plus, there's that fresh coat of snow on the ground. Maybe more on the way this week. It's spring, but it doesn't really feel like it in Minneapolis, that's for sure. Now, the 3.5 inches of snow that you have on the ground was thanks to that clipper that's still moving through the Midwest. Here we go. We've got Fort Wayne. You're still seeing some snow. The I-75 corridor in Ohio is starting to pick up the snow. Not quite all the way to Columbus. That'll come a little bit later. As we shift west, there's still some steady snows on 65 and 69. And then Chicago, lingering snow for you, too. So that storm not done yet. And we can time this all out for you as we go through the rest of the day. The snow leaves northern Indiana, enters central Ohio, but kind of loses its luster a bit as we go through the day. A little bit of enhancement once you get towards the Pittsburgh area and especially towards the Appalachian chain. You get that extra lift from the mountains themselves. So yeah, we could see some snow into northern Virginia, especially along those highest peaks. So that's something to watch for. In Fort Wayne, a few hours of snow still to go, then cloudy and cold as we go through the night. Some clearing, which only lets it get even colder. And speaking of cold, next weekend, what's happening here? The eastern half of the nation is going to be brutal, 15 to 20 degrees below your averages, just when everybody wants to get outside and enjoy a nice spring weekend. Doesn't look like it's going to happen, staying well below average for both Saturday and Sunday. What that means in a place like Atlanta will be a tease of warmth when you're in the office or in school, and just when you want to get outside, you're back to the 50s on Saturday. We can also look at Nashville, nice and warm here midweek, mid-70s, and again, you go out for the weekend, upper 40s to low 50s Friday to Saturday. Viv.
All right. Meanwhile, in California, after another winter with little snow, drastic new rules are going into place to save water. Now, the state would need some 11 trillion gallons of water to recover from its drought. And with a little moisture in sight, state lawmakers are working on a relief plan, as NBC's Miguel Amaguer shows us.
This is the crisis crippling California. A drought so devastating, NASA's senior water scientist is sounding the alarm.
If we don't take measures to conserve our surface water in our reservoirs, we have about a year's worth of water left, so it will be gone.
Reservoirs are dangerously low because the snowpack that supplies a third of the state's water is just 13% of average. This is Yosemite's Half Dome in 2011. And now the view today. Entering its fourth consecutive year of drought, the Golden State is turning deep red. 40% of California is in exceptional drought, the most severe category. Well, yeah. Governor Brown told Chuck Todd there's no greater crisis facing the state.
It does take time, and we are running out of time because it is not raining.
Brown wants $1 billion for water infrastructure and to help struggling communities, but many call the plan a Band-Aid. In the Central Valley, farmers are abandoning fields and jobs are drying up. This food bank alone helps 350,000 people.
But we get people come in from the county now that lives on the fringes, and they work in the fields.
Now, statewide, lawn watering is limited. While at restaurants, you won't get a glass of water unless you ask for it. This is the new Liquid Gold, now harder to find and more valuable than ever.
And here's a look at the drought monitor. Now, 3 weeks ago, or 3 months ago, we had 78% of the state of California in extreme drought. And now it is 67%. So we have come a ways, but we still have a ways to go.
Yeah, and this is supposed to be the wet season, and there just hasn't been enough storms out west. Mm-hmm. In the east, however, you're seeing the clash of the seasons. Snow around Lake Michigan thanks to a clipper.
Meanwhile, spring storms could also fire up later this week over the east. We've got the timetable for you, so keep it tuned right here.
This program brought to you by AARP, Real Possibilities. Covert Ops, Double Agent, Spy Thriller, You Don't Know ARP. Thanks to the AARP Tech program, this guy is spying on his new grandson. AARP Tech gets people better connected to technology to better connect with each other with social media, digital devices, and apps. If you don't think hashtag love dad when you think AARP, then you don't know ARP. Find more surprising possibilities and get to know us at aarp.org/possibilities.
Sometimes bigger is better, but other times bigger just gets in the way. At Brother, we know the biggest printer isn't always the best fit for every office. So we've come up with a bigger idea. Don't supersize, optimize. See how we can help you put the right printers in all the right places and help reduce your costs. Now that's big. Brother, at your side. Learn more at don'tsupersizeoptimize.com.
You've probably seen images of animal abuse before. And if you're anything like me, you might have wanted to turn away. Because the thought of an innocent animal being harmed is very painful to see, and it's even harder to believe. But the images of animal cruelty are real, and they are undeniable. Behind every one of these images are the eyes of a living and breathing, suffering animal. They're depending on us to rescue them. If we turn away, they lose all hope. So I'm asking you not to turn away. Because as painful as these images are to watch, they shed light on a disturbing reality that so many animals face every single day of their lives. This is why I'm asking you to join me in helping these animals right now. Please visit this website or call the number on your screen right now and join the ASPCA with your $18 monthly donation. It's only 60 cents a day. And I can tell you, your donation will help animals immediately. Rescue them from terribly abusive situations, giving them medical attention, food, and loving care. Please make that call. Or go online to join in the next 10 minutes. We will send you the photo of an animal you're helping and this ASPCA t-shirt free with our thanks. The more I learn about animal abuse, the more I realize we cannot pretend that it's not happening. And if we all do our part to help, we can save the lives of so many animals who are hurting. Please go online or call now.
Neighbors always making weird inventions out of junk in their garage. We just gave them their own TV show.
Come on, Wind.
I think I just made Mother Nature my bitch.
One man's trash.
This is perfect.
Is another man's wood-powered Jeep gasifier.
Brainstormers, Sundays at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 86 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, generally cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 88. Tonight, some cloud. Thunderstorm is possible. Low 68. Winds west at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, partly cloudy. Slight chance of a rain shower. High 87. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Yesterday it was sunny. Oh, you all thought you were gonna put your coats away? Think again, because now you need your coat, your hat, your boots, your shoes. Chicago for you.
Ha ha, that's Chicago for you, okay? It's 7:30 here on Weather Center Live. I'm Vivian Brown.
And I'm Mark Elliott. And that snow came in just in time for rush hour. Chicago nailed by snow at a very poor time.
Mm-hmm. And among all of the commuters this morning, we had our very own Keith Carson there.
Yeah, he shows us what conditions were like as some of the heaviest snow bands were whipping through Chicagoland.
Well, last winter, we were in Chicago a lot here at the Weather Channel with a crazy winter, over 80 inches of snow up to this date. That was last year. This year, still about 10 inches above average, sitting around 44, 45 inches of snow. But then this little beauty came in, a pretty strong clipper. Now, clippers are usually associated with lighter snowfall rates and 1 to 3 inches of total snowfall. That's not really the case with this. We have a pretty good wind on it, pretty strong bands of snow as well. There's a convective nature to this, giving us some thunder sleet down to the south earlier in the morning. This is 294, a bypass outside of Chicago, and as you can see, things getting really rough here. Now, most people in Chicago are obviously good at dealing with snow. The road crews have been out throughout the morning. However, when it thumps snow like this, there's really nothing that you can do. The best you can do is trying to keep it passable and keep it moving. They have done that thus far. They'll have to struggle with that until it starts tapering off later on this morning. Expecting about 5 inches of snow or so, but certainly with these snowfall rates, wouldn't be surprised if we end up a little bit over that in some communities. Chicago's airport also dealing with that, some delays on the inbound side of things as well. To add insult to injury, 1 week ago here in Chicago, the high temperature was 73 degrees. Back to you.
Thanks, Keith. Just not fair. And of course, flights were impacted too. At O'Hare alone, for flights into or out of O'Hare, 504 cancellations today. 5 inches of snow in O'Hare, 4 at Midway. Both saw delays, obviously some cancellations, and we're still seeing snow now. So, Viv, let's talk about where that snow's going next.
Yes, we are, even though it's come to an end in the Chicago area for the most part, but all of that snow is pushing across northern Indiana. Again, you saw the first little batch to move through Chicago, but we were watching just 30 minutes ago the second little kind of a backlash of this snow coming back into the Chicago area. This should measure less than a half of an inch, perhaps. Again, it's the last little vestiges of the whole system as the bulk of the rest of the snow continues to move off to the east over northern Indiana and the northwestern parts of Ohio. Notice that it does stay to the south of you, Detroit, and basically to the south of you, too, as well, Chicago. But take a look at the legacy of this storm. South of Minneapolis, we had very heavy amounts where you see the purple shading here from southeast Minnesota right through southwestern Wisconsin, including the Fenimore area. 15 inches of snow from this fast-moving clipper system. Yes, it's fast-moving, but it has quite a punch with it. Again, as it continues to ride along the jet stream winds and slide on into the Ohio Valley. So here's a look at the rest of the afternoon hours. The snow will slowly but surely taper off as the system quickly moves away. So we'll keep you updated in terms of the final totals. Back to you, Mark.
Thanks, Viv. You know, some are calling this a drought when it comes to severe weather. Storm chasers haven't been out there to track anything this year so far. Earlier today, we talked with meteorologist and storm chaser Reed Timmer. He shared his take on the slower start to this severe season.
I think this is about normal. I mean, usually we don't get into the heart of tornado season and pure storm chasing season when we're on the road nonstop until mid to late April on. I mean, I remember I've been in school for 17 years, and finals week was always that really active time when everybody gets out and starts storm chasing. But you know, there was 2003 was pretty active during late March, 2004, March 27, and also 2007, March 28 was pretty active in the Southern Plains, and all of those years were El Nino years as well. So this coming storm season, it looks maybe the Southern Plains could be more active, and maybe tomorrow and the next day are a sign of things to come.
So we'll have to see if that is indeed a sign of things to come. There's certainly some changes on the way. Tulsa, one place that'll feel that change tonight. The winds will pick up. We could be looking at the threat of severe weather as well. A couple of different forces at work here to give you those severe ingredients. So let's talk about this 1-2 stormy punch. It starts off overnight. You got to quickly switch your mind here. Switch from winter to spring because, hey, we haven't had any tornado watches issued so far this March. It's the first time on record since 1970 that has occurred. So this is it's going to be a quick return into the severe season. Let's start tomorrow with southerly winds bringing up warm air and moist air from the Gulf of Mexico. Just a little bit aloft, though, we do have a low-level jet stream that's turned in regards to the southerly winds coming at the surface, more westerly as we look just a little bit aloft. And then the upper-level jet stream, notice it's kind of displaced from this other kind of patchwork of winds. So it's not exactly aligned. That's why we're not seeing the most ideal setup, the perfect textbook case of seeing tornadoes and severe storms. But there's enough to give us some organized storms. So we are looking at a tornado threat here, Kansas into Missouri from overnight into Tuesday, starting off as individual cells, then kind of lining out as this storm goes by. And so tonight we've got the red zone up mostly across Kansas, starting to stretch down into northern Oklahoma and western Missouri as well. By tomorrow, though, this zone stretches out and gets a little bit more substantial from Oklahoma into Illinois. Again, gusty winds will be the biggest threat. And then we do the whole thing again. Notice a second low comes in a very similar area. So again, at the surface, southerly winds, a little bit aloft. They're coming out of a more westerly direction. And once again, the upper level jet stream is displaced a little bit compared to the winds in that warm sector, what we call south of the warm front, where we're going to see the storm. So again, not the perfect setup for tornadoes, but enough of a setup that it's something that we have to be concerned about. Storms really blossom as we go through the day on Wednesday, and along that cold front, there could be some nasty weather. Viv, over to you.
Well, speaking of spring, are you on spring break this week? Well, heads up for you, we have storms that could interrupt your plans. Like here at Panama City, you can see the low clouds kind of hanging around. Not a whole lot of people out on the beach, but rightfully so. Not the best of beach days. It'll be cloudy for the rest of the day, we think. Temperatures in the low 70s. Now, tomorrow, maybe some peaks of sunshine with mid to upper 70s. That'll be the case on Wednesday, too. Thursday, the next chance of a few showers, perhaps. Temperatures in the middle 70s. But Friday, we'll end the week on a pretty decent note. The temperature will be the coolest, only 70 degrees, but partly sunny skies will prevail. Mark?
Thanks, Viv. And, you know, speaking of spring break, a lot of people head into the waters. Another thing that we haven't done much over the past several months, right? Because it's been so cold. Well, now we're getting into spring break time. It's time to talk about rip currents again. This is one of those things that is so dangerous at the beaches. The waves breaking, and you think that the kind of quiet zone would be the safe area where you're not seeing those breaking waves. That's actually because the water is leaving. You get a pressure gradient because of the water piling up. It has to leave somewhere, so where you don't see the breaking waves and it looks calmer, that might actually be the more dangerous area. That's where the rip currents are bringing that water back out from the shore, back out to the ocean. Turning this all on its head to give you another view, if you are stuck in one of these, you'll start getting swept out to sea, and the natural instinct is to start trying to swim to shore. But what you really should do is to swim parallel to shore. You'll get back into that onshore current, and that will bring you back in towards shore, and that's how you'll stay safe if you do get caught in a rip current.
All the while, it's a cold start to the week across the Northeast.
Yeah, temperatures in some places more than 20 degrees below average. So we're going to talk and tell you how long that cool weather will stick around.
Plus, how this harsh winter is causing a problem for a breakfast table staple.
Oh, yeah, maple syrup impacted by the weather. We'll show you how that happens coming up after your local on the 8s.
Currently in our area, 83 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, generally cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 88. Tonight, some clouds. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 68. Winds west at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, partly cloudy. Slight chance of a rain shower. High 87. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Hmm. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Everybody knows that, Parker.
Well, did you know auctioneers make bad grocery store clerks?
It'll be $23.50. Now $75, $23.75. Hold on, I'm hitting it now, $23.75, $24. Hey, $24, $24 and a quarter. Now half, $24 and a half and $75 and $25. Now a quarter, hey, $26 and a quarter. Hold on, I'm hitting it now, $20. You want to do it? $5 and a quarter. Sold to the man in the khaki jacket.
GEICO, 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Introducing the Citi Double Cash Card. It's a cash back win-win. With 1% when you buy and 1% as you pay. With two ways to earn on purchases, it makes a lot of other cards seem one-sided.
I went to Ancestry.com, but I thought, I'm not going to make it very far. And then it happened. I got a leaf. I could actually see my grandfather's draft card from World War I. And it all started with my first leaf.
Cheez-It grooves are the best of both worlds, like a Cheez-It and a chip.
Oh, you just put them together.
Yes.
Closer. Closer. They're kissing.
We take time for our cheese to mature in our crispy Cheez-It grooves.
I have the worst cold with this runny nose. I better take something.
DayQuil Cold and Flu doesn't treat your runny nose.
Seriously?
Alka-Seltzer Plus Cold and Cough fights your worst cold symptoms plus your runny nose.
Oh, what a relief it is.
The Fiat 500 isn't alone anymore. It's part of a big Italian family.
You know, some people have told me reverse mortgages sound too good to be true. I mean, you get cash out of your home, no monthly payments, and still own your home. There's got to be a catch, right, Jesse? Well, there isn't. It's like any other mortgage, only with reverse mortgage, the loan's paid back when the last borrower leaves the home. In fact, reverse mortgages are based on a notion that President Reagan signed into law over 25 years ago in order to help seniors remain in their homes. If you're 62 or older and own your own home, you may qualify for a government-insured reverse mortgage with AAG that allows you to turn the equity in your home into tax-free cash. And with AAG, there are never any credit score requirements.
Call 1-800-661-0312 now to receive a new free information kit, including a reverse mortgage guide and DVD, personal stories from people like you, and a brand new family guide for children and loved ones, all absolutely free with no obligation.
AAG can help you pay off credit card debt, eliminate monthly mortgage payments, and provide some real retirement security.
Call 1-800-661-0312 today to get your free AAG Reverse Mortgage Information Kit and Bonus DVD.
In the kit, you'll receive a helpful three-part guide. The first will show you how a government-insured reverse mortgage allows you to access the equity in your home as tax-free cash. 500,000 people have already done it. The second booklet contains stories told by people just like you who've had their lives changed forever using a reverse mortgage. And the third guide is full of helpful answers and information for children and loved ones.
Call 1-800-661-0312 now to receive your information kit and DVD, all absolutely free.
They're simply an effective way for folks just like you to get the cash you need to enjoy your retirement.
Call 1-800-661-0312 now to receive your information kit and DVD, all absolutely free. Call 1-800-661-0312 now.
AAG, the best advice for a better life.
You're watching the Weather Channel. Thank you so much for joining us as we look out live across the most walkable city in America. That would be Boston. And we are walking around with all the sunshine. The sunshine is slowly but surely melting the snow. You still see some piles of snow on some of the grassy areas there. But I'll tell you what, the chill will begin to ease across the Northeast. I know it's cold now, but as we progress deeper in the week, the afternoon highs will be more representative of springtime, that's for sure. Right now, again, sub-freezing in Boston, even back to Binghamton, New York, checking in with 19 degrees. It's 35 in New York City and 38 in Philadelphia. A little less cold in D.C. with mid-40s right now. But you can see how the jet stream is taking a dive, and that means some cooler air, again, allowed to sink south of the border. Now, as we go through time, the jet stream will start to push north of the New York City area, north of Philadelphia, so that's going to allow more of a warmer feel of things to take over the Northeast. So while it will be another chilly day today, each day as we go through the week is going to get less cold and less cold, as we're talking mid-40s tomorrow in New York City, upper 30s in the Boston area, and then mid-40s on Wednesday in Boston, and staying pretty much in the mid-40s on Wednesday in New York City. But again, these temperatures running maybe 2 to 5 degrees below average versus the 10 to 15 degrees below average as we start off the week, including today. So here we go, stair-stepping our way to warmer air, really taking a huge leap here on Thursday. We're forecasting a high of 66 degrees when the average is 52, so well above average by the end of the week versus well below average at what we've seen so far in the New York City area. Again, not only New York City, but the same holds true for Boston and Philadelphia and D.C., most of the Northeast, as we'll take that chill or take a notch off the extremely chilly air that we began the week with here over much of the Northeast. Now this.
Now an important question. Have you eaten pancakes or waffles recently? And did you use maple syrup? Well, spring's late arrival is making it tough on the farmers who make that maple syrup. Lyle Merrifield owns Merrifield Farm in Gorham, Maine, and joins us live now. First, Lyle, thanks so much for joining us today.
Oh, you're welcome, Mark. Thanks for asking.
Let's talk about this maple syrup and weather. How does that combine in order to get us that delightful addition to breakfast?
Well, the weather hasn't really cooperated with most of the producers, that's for sure. It's been awfully cold, and we've had some very moderate runs. I mean, there has been some syrup made in the southern part of the state, but certainly we haven't been into the season as deep as we normally are by this time.
So you're saying cold not good for your progress on getting maple syrup. Why is that? What's the ideal condition for harvesting?
Well, what we like to have is we like to have certainly freezing evenings and nights, but we need that temperature to be up to 40, maybe 45 by 10 or 11 the next day to get the sap flow moving in those trees.
And that's because the sap itself would be frozen and thus not running out of the trees?
Correct. Yep.
So give me your ideal setup. Other than, like, does it affect the weather? Does the weather affect the quality of that sap that you'll get? If you get those temperatures to be ideal, is that then ideal maple syrup?
Absolutely. It makes you good sap production, and with the cool nights, it keeps everything preserved well. So with those fluctuations in temperature, it can certainly give us, excellent sap yields. And looking at the forecast ahead of us, it looks like we're going to get some of those conditions that we need.
And we're looking at some of the images on the screen right now of the different colors of maple syrup. How does that come into play? Is that related to the weather at all, or just the tree that you're getting it from?
All right, it can be, and it can be the tree you're getting it from, but typically your different grades of syrup will be put into the time of the season. As the season drags on, normally you're making a darker syrup.
All right, Lyle, thanks so much for the information. Fascinating stuff, and hopefully we'll get that perfect, ideal condition so we can get more maple syrup flowing soon.
Love that maple syrup. Well, stay with us. Winter is not giving up easily. Ahead, who can expect to see snow from not one, but two blasts of winter weather? Plus, a group of young scientists and inventors display their new ideas at the White House this morning. We'll show you the best new technology, all invented by people who soccer practice. But these are the new minds of the world, and we'll share more of their stories and their inventions coming up. And this is new video trying to clear off the streets of the light snow that we had this morning in Chi-Town.
All right, listen up. Out on that field today, you will be ready for anything. And I want you to always remember, this is the greatest team you will ever be part of.
And when they're asked, what did you do to make a difference in the world? They can say, I became a soldier.
Hey, You know your dentures can move. Unlike natural teeth, try Fixident Plus TrueFeel. The smooth formula helps keep dentures in place. It's free of flavors and colorants for a closer feeling to natural teeth. Fixident and forget it.
Sundays.
One man's trash
did the work.
Is another man's totally awesome beer can space heater.
Hi.
Brainstormers. Sundays at 9, only on the Weather Channel.
You know you're going to go out in bad weather.
We're willing to take a lot of risk.
He has no heartbeat, he's got no pulse.
These people are counting on us.
So let's go!
I've never been so terrified.
When you go out there, it's dangerous.
Currently in our area, 83 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, generally cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 88. Tonight, some clouds. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 68. Winds west at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, partly cloudy. Slight chance of a rain shower. High 87. Here's our 7-day outlook.
When you're hungry for the craveable taste of tender fish and shrimp, nothing's better than Long John Silver's. Now, for a limited time, enjoy our new crispy golden fish and shrimp basket for just $3.99 at Long John Silver's.
Grandpa Bodie. Grandma said you used to be out of control.
Really? I guess I did take some risks. I trained a little bit differently. I was a little too honest sometimes.
The media is useless.
You were out of control.
But not always.
It's more than the cloud. It's multi-layered security and flexibility. With CenturyLink, you get advanced technology solutions, including cloud and hosting services, all from a trusted IT partner. CenturyLink, your link to what's next.
Incredible. I've been Claritin clear for 10 days.
When your allergy symptoms start, doctors recommend taking one Claritin every day of your allergy season for continuous relief.
With powerful 24-hour non-drowsy Claritin, live Claritin clear every day.
Hut, hut. When it comes to losing weight, everyone has a number. And if you want to get your performance back and feel great, do what I did. One call and I lost it all. 22 pounds gone.
Lose weight fast with Nutrisystem's Fast 5 Plus Kit. Lose 5 pounds in your first week, plus 1 inch off your waist or your money back, guaranteed. Nutrisystem has everything you need to feel better, look better, and perform better at any age, faster than ever before.
I haven't felt this good in years. Thank you, Nutrisystem. I lost 8 pounds in the first week.
Order your 28-day Nutrisystem plan right now, including Fast 5 Plus. Get 1 week of meals, plus 1 week of energizing shakes and craving crusher shakes, free. New food selections, new expert guides. Call now and lock in 2014 prices, and shipping is free. Whether your numbers make the right call.
Call 855-789-FIN now and lose your first 5 pounds fast.
Altec Roofing, the area's premier roofing company since 1984. We are a family-owned and operated business, and we specialize in roof replacement, repair, and new construction of all roof types. Altec Roofing is proud to have an A-plus rating with the Better Business Bureau and have received numerous awards for quality and workmanship. Join our legions of satisfied customers today by calling Altec Roofing for a free quote on any of your roofing needs.
Maxwell's is now open in the Driftwood Plaza of Jupiter. Gold, silver, coins, diamonds, jewelry, paintings, and objects of art. If you don't want it or wear it, sell it to Maxwell's. We buy and sell diamonds of all sizes, clarity, and condition up to 10 carats in size and above. We have decades of experience buying and selling gold, coins, diamonds, and objects of art. Maxwell's, located in the Driftwood Plaza on US 1 in Jupiter, Florida.
So let's go!
When you go out there, it's dangerous.
Brand new video into us now on the Weather Channel. This shows people clearing the snow that fell in Chicago, 5 inches at O'Hare's International, and more than 500 flights were canceled because of this quick-moving system with this heavy burst of snow in the area. A couple of inches, by the way, in downtown Chicago. So the Clipper snow for the Midwest, that is our big weather story of the day. That system is still providing some snow across the southern part of Michigan. Now, you can see you, Detroit. You are not in the snow zone so far, and we don't think that you will be in it. We think the bulk of the snow will stay to your south. But speaking of areas to your south, you can see around Toledo, Ohio, they're getting the snow right now, and the snow extends across the northeastern parts of Indiana. And putting it kind of in 3D mode as we flip the radar a little bit for you, you can see the southern extent of the snow here, indicated by the blue, by the way, is extending down across the north central parts of Indiana. And again, encompassing much of northwestern Ohio, but has not moved into your area if you're in Cleveland, so we'll continue to watch you. Chicago, your last little vestiges of snow, maybe a half of an inch still to come, but for the most part, nothing impressive in terms of additional accumulations, because as we look at the forecast for the radar, we anticipate this area of low pressure to quickly continue to slide on off to the east and south, and maybe by tomorrow could bring a stray snow shower as far east as the D.C. area, so we'll keep you updated on that, but we do think that it'll start to wane quite a bit as it moves off to the east. So Columbus, Ohio, here's a look at your forecast. Maybe a little bit of snow around the 6, 7 o'clock hour this evening, but then not amounting to all that much because the snow will not last long as it gives way to cloudy skies. But talk about the history of this system. We had heavy amounts of snow in southern Minnesota, and look at this across the southwestern parts of Wisconsin. Fenimore picked up 15 inches of snow from this Clipper system that we're watching today. But believe it or not, there's another system that we'll be watching as we progress through the next couple of days, as the jet stream shows this little kink here, and that will allow the colder air to push back in. This is into Wednesday afternoon. Again, snow and another cold pocket of air will slide south of the border over the Dakotas into Minnesota, starting off as a chilly rain and a wet snow event here across this region, so we'll keep you updated on the final snow totals. Mark?
Now, have you ever heard of a 12-year-old CEO? What about owning a patent on new technology before you even own a driver's license? Well, the White House was full of kids like that this morning, and you know what? Our own Anaritis Rodriguez introduces us to some of them.
It's not every day the president gets to shoot a marshmallow through an air gun across the state dining room. But at the White House Science Fair, innovations like this kid-designed device get presidential praise, some play.
Let's go look at the marshmallows, see what happens.
And maybe even a patent.
My invention is the Hiccupop. It's a lollipop that treats the hiccups, and I applied for a patent.
And you actually got it?
Yes, I got it about a year ago.
So you can sell this on the market?
Yes.
Don't be fooled by their age.
I want to be an engineer.
We invented a device that can help people turn pages in a book.
Already, many of these kids are CEOs of their own companies.
I want to actually start the company, and I profit, expand.
So you want to be the CEO of your own company?
Yes, ma'am.
Joshua Page's product, a magnetic wristband that can charge a phone without electricity. For the fifth year, more than 100 of the country's youngest and brightest minds putting their science experiments to the presidential test.
I'm 16 years old, and I created a wearable sensor system that detects the wandering of Alzheimer's patients.
The National Science Foundation says 3/4 of professionals working in STEM fields are men. The fair's purpose is to encourage more girls and minorities to study science.
I just really want to inspire people to do something bigger and have more women in technology, really.
Amazing kids there, that's for sure.
Yes.
And now the hunt for spring continues as Weather Center Live rolls on.
All right, Alex Wilson and Dave Swartz track the threat of spring storms and who's still struggling with winter.
That includes Chicago. You're clearing away from fresh snow that fell at a very inopportune time during the morning rush. We'll show you who's impacted on the drive home coming up.
Currently in our area, 81 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. This afternoon, generally cloudy. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. High 88. Tonight, some clouds. A stray shower or thunderstorm is possible. Low 68. Winds west at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Tuesday, partly cloudy. Slight chance of a rain shower. High 87. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Welcome to Weather Center Live. On a Monday afternoon, I'm Dave Schwartz.
And I'm Alex Wilson. We are into our third full day of spring, but you wouldn't know in one part of the country.
And take a look at video from earlier today in Chicago. Traffic was moving just fine here on Interstate 294, but Chicago police report dozens of spin-outs and accidents across the city. Also, about 400 flights in and out of O'Hare have been canceled today.
On Sunday, the show even caused several accidents on highway south of the Twin Cities, car after car in a ditch on Interstate 35. Minnesota State Patrol tells us they responded to 164 crashes across the state on Sunday. So everyone there is saying, where's spring? Well, here it is. We've got a risk of springtime thunderstorms, some of which could be severe as we get into the middle part of the week.
And even the possibility of thunderstorms today. Now, let's turn to severe weather expert Dr. Greg Forbes. He is tracking several days of storms, and it all starts tonight. Dr. Forbes, it's yours.
Yeah, Dave, we've been on a record low pace, especially for the month of March, tornado-wise, hail-wise, but that's all going to end over the next few days. Starting tonight through at least Thursday, we'll have a threat for some tornadoes and certainly a good bit of hail with that. Take a look. Here's this is for March. We have not yet in 2015 in March had any tornadoes. 1969 didn't either. That year, the first tornado was today. So if we can get past today in this year, we'll have a new record slow start for the month of March, and I think we'll probably do that. We've also been very quiet for hail. Going into the weekend, we were the quietest start to a whole year for hail. We've now only had 10 reports, but that's one above the previous slow start, which is 9 in 1958. The average, look at that, 820. And some days alone have had 500 in previous years, 1,500 or so in some of those years to this point. So it's very quiet. We'll see some hail probably tonight. Might be marginal, though, in size. That has to be 1 inch or larger to qualify as severe. These are the dew points, a measure of the moisture in the air. Usually 52 or 50, at least, is what I think is needed for severe storms. So right now that's in Oklahoma. There is a front between that and the Kansas area. But some of the moisture sneaks up into the Dodge City area and a little bit elevated overnight. And then as we head into tomorrow, some of that higher moisture gets into at least the southern parts of Missouri, parts of Arkansas, Oklahoma, and up into north central Texas. So the moisture is not ample, but it is returning. Should be enough for some severe thunderstorms, and then maybe even sneaking into the St. Louis area as we head into tomorrow evening. So tonight, there could be some hail, maybe marginal size, maybe up to 1 inch in diameter, central and eastern parts of Kansas, maybe by morning over into the Kansas City area. Then tomorrow, as that moisture continues to increase and a surface low forms there in eastern parts of Kansas, we'll combine that with about 5,000 feet. Winds that are more from the west-southwest or southwest and a little bit stronger, maybe 50 miles per hour. So in that shear, in that turning of the winds with height, the atmosphere starts to roll. That lets the thunderstorms tilt that up into the vertical, and the thunderstorms start to rotate. And what we have not seen for basically since early January is a disturbance in the northern branch of the jet stream coming directly in with a jet stream that taps into some of that moisture. We've had in the month of March, a number of these old cutoff low disturbances come across Texas, but none like this one. So this is the first true spring severe weather threat that we'll see anywhere from this red shaded area, eastern Oklahoma, up across parts of Arkansas, Missouri, and into western parts of Illinois, with hail damaging winds and at least a couple of tornadoes. Not a huge threat on the 10-point tornado condition index. I've given three there for the red shaded areas. That means about a 30% chance of a tornado within 50 miles. Now, there'll be a two-part to this. The second part will be that there'll be two of these disturbances. This shows the mid-level spin of the atmosphere. The first little U-shaped dip in the jet stream, mid-level jet stream, comes in tomorrow. There comes the second one that will follow in for Wednesday. The one on the first one by Wednesday gets up into the Great Lakes, outruns the moisture, but the next one is on its way in. So even into Wednesday, we could see from southern Illinois down into Oklahoma some hail, some damaged winds, again a chance of a tornado. The tornado condition index again in these areas on Wednesday will be a 3. Then as we head into Thursday, some of that severe weather could get into parts of Virginia and North Carolina as well. So it is a stormy pattern, as finally we've got a jet stream that is beginning to give some threat to areas where we typically would have already had it in the month of March. Let's hope everyone stays safe. Alex?
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Dr. Forbes. And there's also a wintry side to this spring storm. Take a look. This is tomorrow night. Notice the snow up into parts of Wisconsin, Minnesota, and North Dakota. Freezing rain possible in northwest Ohio and Michigan. On Wednesday, we keep snow in the northern tier, northern parts of Minnesota, North Dakota, and Wisconsin. Wednesday night, even the UP of Michigan getting in on some of that. Upper lower Michigan could see a little snow north of Traverse City. You'll see that mix of rain and snow with showers further off to the south. Let's take a live look at the city of Chicago. What do you say, Dave?
Yeah, well, I say we have a little light snow,
yeah.
But I see Michigan.